What's going on, guys? Billy here, and yesterday we got a brand new firmware update for the DJI Mavic Mini. Released on December 31st, 2019, this version number is 01.00.0400 and is 39 megabytes in size to download. To take full advantage of some of these features, you also want to make sure that your DJI Fly application is updated to the newest version, which is currently version 1.0.4. The following patch notes accompany this firmware update, so if you want to read through all of them, go ahead and pause this video really quickly, as now we are going to begin checking out some of the larger changes. Alright, so the biggest change that can be found within this firmware update is the fact that we can now unlock authorization zones or unlock geo zones with our Mavic Mini. This is a feature that comes standard on pretty much all modern DJI drones, and the fact that it was omitted from the Mavic Mini was kind of weird. I mean, I figured they would put this in the drone as soon as it was released, so if you live in an authorization zone, you can of course get authorization through the DJI Fly application and then go and fly your drone, but that wasn't the case. But now we can. So through the DJI Fly application, actually, if we jump back in here to the map, you'll notice I'm at East Shore Park right now, just outside of New Haven. This is New Haven Regional Airport. I'm inside of an authorization zone, and before this update, I would not be able to fly my Mavic Mini here because it just wouldn't let me. So let's jump back in here to go fly. Up at the top left corner, you see that it says geo zones. We'll go to takeoff, so we'll prime the motors by pushing down and in. It says here aircraft in authorization zone 1 to take off. It says authorization zone, so when you go and see it says unlock area, we'll tap on unlock. It's going to require us to put in some information, so I will put in my phone number here. Then once we hit agree and hit request, it sends us a code. Now, the good thing about iOS is it automatically puts that in there for us, the code. So usually that code will be sent to your text messages, and then you'd go and input that code within the DJI Fly application. Now we confirm the following statements, saying that I am qualified to fly in this area because I applied for LANC. I agree to assume full liability for flying in this area. I agree to upload DJI device hardware information. We tap on OK, and now it says that it was not accepted, although I'm able to fly. I agree to assume full liability for flying in this area. Okay, so it's a little bit different than the DJI Go application. I do have to say this is the first time I'm unlocking within the DJI Fly app. I usually unlock with the Mavic Mini like the DJI Go application, but it worked despite it saying that it failed. That actually happens to me sometimes within the DJI Go application. It says the unlocking process fails. Most of the time it ends up working, and right now I am able to fly within this authorization zone because I applied for the LANC and because now DJI added it to their software. So if we tap on the map again, we'll zoom out a little bit here. You'll notice I am within the area, the airspace of Tweed New Haven International Airport, not international, regional airport, and now we can fly the drone, the Mavic Mini. Alright, so that was by far the biggest change that was introduced with this new firmware update for the Mavic Mini and the new update for the DJI Fly application. Now, despite the patch notes being fairly extensive after that, there's not many other changes. I wouldn't say they're notable in any way. They kind of clean up some things on the back end, introduce a few smaller features, because again, unlocking those geozones is something that was priority one for DJI with this firmware update. Now, if we go down the list here, the second bullet point states that it added a feature that disables takeoff when the GPS signal is weak, so when you have under 8 satellites and the environment light is not sufficient. This feature can be disabled manually. Here's the thing, I haven't seen this put into effect, so despite me being inside having a low number of satellites and also there being some lower lights, the drone was still able to take off inside. And I dug through all of the settings, I dug through the different menus, and I wasn't able to find anything that allowed me to turn this on or turn this off. I even reached out to DJI support regarding the rest of these patch notes, and they said they couldn't give me any more information just because it's such a brand new update. They contacted the engineers, and as of right now, this is something that sounds like a good idea in theory, because if you're a brand new drone operator and you just got the Mavic Mini, you want to make sure you fly with GPS because it helps you throughout all aspects of flight with this drone. But as of right now, even though it's in the patch notes, it's not available within the drone. All right, so moving on to the next bullet point on the patch notes list, it basically says that whenever we're asked to do a compass calibration, it's going to force us to do it. We're not gonna be able to take off with the compass not being calibrated when asked to do so. And also when the environment light is low, it's going to make us calibrate the compass just to make sure that the flight is more accurate because it's not gonna be able to rely on those vision positioning sensors. But here's the thing, just like the last piece of information in the patch notes, the last bullet point, this doesn't work. So right now I've got a screen recording running. I've got the drone sitting next to me. It says compass calibration required in the top left corner. It says that we want to make sure that we calibrate the compass, but we can still take off. So I don't know. It's a little bit weird. Those two points seem like something that DJI wanted to add in this update. And despite me updating my firmware on my drone and updating the application, they're not working. All right, so the final four patch notes that accompany this firmware update, the final four bullet points are fairly small. The first one says that it adjusted flight altitude and distance in payload mode. So now it actually limits the distance and the height that you can fly when payload mode is turned on. Also, it says that it added a warning prompt for battery cycle. So now within the about page of the DJI Fly application, you can see how much a specific battery was charged, which is a very good piece of information to have to make sure you're not using a battery that is old and has a ton of cycles. And it kind of gives you an idea at how much you've actually used a specific battery. Also, it says that it reduced noise during self-diagnostics after powering on. So once you turn the drone on and once it goes through all of its calibrations, the noise has been decreased. I personally haven't noticed much of a difference. And the final thing on these patch notes on the list is that it says it fixed an issue where linking was abnormal in some regions, which I can say that I never ran into. So guys, this update was fairly minor in size, I would say, but it gives us a huge feature, which is unlocking geozones and being able to fly our drone in these authorized spaces, which is something the Mavic Mini couldn't do when it was first released. Anyway guys, hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, I'll talk to you later. Peace.